Some people take videos of their kids. Some people photograph their dogs. I'm Bill Daley, and I take shots of pies. So I'm going to decide I'm going to make a maple orange walnut pie from A Year of Pies by Ashley English. It's a great new pie cookbook. Today I'm going to make two pie crusts. I'm going to start with two sticks of butter frozen. I'm going to split them, each stick of butter, in half, and then cube them and put them in the food processor. And then I'm going to scoop up about 2.5 cups of flour. As you can see, there's quite a lot of excess. Just use the back of your knife blade and sweep the top of the measuring cup clean. And here is the butter and flour in the food processor. And the next shot here, you'll see the flour and butter's been cut coarsely, and it almost looks like ground cornmeal. And then I'll put in the ice water, and it sort of makes a very rough sort of paste. And put it out on the counter, and it just looks like it's a crumbled mess. And this part, as I've always said, scares me, because I keep saying, how can I turn this into a smooth, beautiful pie crust? I do it by smushing, and I use the heel of my hand, which is the coolest part, and just rub that flour and butter across the counter to kind of combine it together, and it makes a beautiful, soft dough that's almost like earlobe soft. So here's my ball of dough. I'm gonna split it in two, because I'm gonna make two different pies, and put them in the refrigerator. You wanna leave them in there for about a half an hour to an hour. All right, so here is the big circle of dough, and I'm gonna kind of pat it down with my rolling pin to flatten it out, and then roll it out. And again, the key here is roll outward strokes. Don't roll down, roll out, so that you try to make a circular dough. And then I'm gonna fold that dough into fourths and lay it in my quiche shell. And then here's my finished tart crust, and I've patched it and rolled the edges so that the sides are a little thicker. So the first thing I need to do is grate the rind of an orange. And I have this little zester here, and I'm just gonna rub it all across the top of the orange and pull off that very aromatic and fragrant skin of the orange. And then, of course, naturally it causes a mess. I'm going to use the tip of my knife to scrape the orange rind out of the grater, which is a real pain in the butt. And then I'm going to add 3 eggs to the 2 tablespoons of orange rind in a bowl, and then 3/4 cup packed brown sugar, and 1/3 cup flour. And then finally, here's an interesting ingredient. It's going to be 1 1/2 cups maple syrup. And then, so it's in there with the maple syrup, in with the eggs, the orange rind, the flour, and melted butter. The recipe called for orange extract, but orange extract has a huge amount of alcohol in it, and I try to make my pies alcohol-free. So I decided I would try orange marmalade in the place of orange extract. Then you whisk all the ingredients together in a bowl, and then add about, I'd say, about 1.5 cups of chopped walnuts, and then just pour it into the pie crust, and you're ready to go. And it's an orange maple walnut pie. This recipe comes from A Year of Pies by Ashley English, and I think it looks pretty damn good. I'm sorry, I should say it looks pretty darn good, since I'm a cook. Actually, I'm not even a cook. I'm a pie baker, so it looks whatever. I think the pie looks good. Thanks for tuning in to Pie Slice with Bill Daley.